This is a demonstration of the rear entertainment modes on the car show GM1210. The GM1210 has the ability to serve three different sources to rear entertainment. The AV1 input out here on the face, the AV2 input that's on the back of the radio, and the DVD source. All three of those can be sent to rear entertainment, and here's how we do it. If we go into the menu and hit the rear menu button, you'll see that there is a rear zone control. Right now it's set to off, meaning that nothing is being sent back to the rear screens. Or we can cycle through AV2, AV1, or DVD sources. So we'll show you here with our displays in the back exactly how those different sources work. The way the system is going to work for rear entertainment is that whatever we switch on the GM1210 is going to be passed out to our rear entertainment screens. And in this case, you can see that currently we've got no input because we don't have a source chosen on the GM1210. But if we want to choose our source, we simply go to our menu, hit our rear options again, and we can cycle through all of our different source options here, and there's no output until we exit our menu on the deck. So now once we do that, we want to watch DVD in the rear. Now you're listening to the radio up front, and in the rear we will be getting our DVD playback. As soon as our DVD player spools up, there we go. Now we're getting DVD playback on the rear screen. If we want to do any of the other sources, for instance AV2, which is the RCA leads on the back of the GM1210, which in our case we've got hooked up to the Crux WVI Wi-Fi video interface, we simply go to rear, we choose our AV2 source, and then exit from that. Again, we're still watching listening to the radio up front, and now we're watching our phone output on the rear screen. So for instance, our playback is all being done from our phone here, and the nice thing about this is rear passengers have complete control over what they're watching directly from the device in their lap. So that can be shared to both headrests in this case, or to an overhead, whatever your screens are, whatever screen setup you have in the rear seat. The same thing can be done on the AV1 input as well. So for instance, in this case, again, AV1 is the mini headphone jack on the face of the radio. We simply plug that in our demo here. We've got that hooked up to an iPod, standard iPod Classic. So we can go play videos on our iPod. And let's start up Toy Story. It's plugged in, so now it's not going to display on the iPod. We'll display that on the rear screens. We do the same thing here. Menu, rear, AV1, because that's our AV1 input, and then back out of that menu, and now on our rear screens, we've got Toy Story 2 off of our iPod playing on the rear screen. And again, we have the ability, or the rear passengers have the ability, to play, pause, fast forward, rewind, etc. Anything they want to do from the back seat, because they have control right in their hand. So having that rear zone output with the multiple sources that are available to be controlled from the GM1210 really makes rear seat entertainment a whole different ballgame with much of that control being put in the hands of the rear seat passengers.